Hi, I'm Dr. Ken Berry, a family physician, and for the next few minutes, I really want to discuss something that's quite important for human health and optimization, and that's potassium and potassium deficiency. And this video is going to be about the 7 most common signs of low potassium or potassium deficiency that your doctor might miss. Some of these signs and symptoms can be quite subtle, and if you're not looking for them and know what to look for, you can overlook them, and then you'll go on suffering from deficiency in potassium and not know you're suffering. So if you know someone who values their health and would like to know if their potassium is optimized or not, please share this video with them in an email, text message, share it on your Facebook, your Twitter, your Instagram. Help me to help other people live their best, optimal, healthiest life. Now, let's talk about, first of all, what potassium does in the human body. It does thousands of things. This video would be hours long if I tried to cover them all, but let's sum it up into 3 big categories. First of all, potassium acts as an electrolyte, and it helps to balance the fluid in your body. And you'll see down in the 7 signs, some of these signs are directly related to that. So balancing your fluid properly is very important. If it's not balanced properly, it can lead to heart failure and other things. And so in that case, we don't want to have low potassium. Also, it functions to help nerves to conduct quickly and very efficiently. If your nerve conduction is slow, that can lead to problems, as we'll see later in this video. And then also, potassium helps your muscles contract optimally and strongly. And you have 3 different types of muscle in your body. You have smooth muscle in your gut and your internal organs. You have cardiac muscle in your heart. And you have striated muscle in your skeletal muscles, the muscles that you actually think of when you make a muscle, right? Now, the serum potassium in your blood is tightly controlled. Your body has to keep it between a certain, usually it's 3.5 to 4.5, somewhere in there. It's very tightly controlled. And so your body, in order to keep your serum potassium level within normal limits, it will rob potassium from your muscles, from your gut, from your nerves, from your bones, even from your brain if it has to, because if without your serum potassium being in this very tight range, you'll quickly die. And your body knows that. And so that's why you can actually go to the doctor and have your serum potassium checked and it'd be normal, but you still be very deficient in potassium. Now let's talk about the 7 signs that you need to know about so that you can know if you potentially have low potassium or not. First of all, number 1 is physical weakness. You feel like you should be able to pick that up, or you feel like you should be able to climb those stairs, but when you try, you become very weak very quickly. Now this sign and all the other signs can be signs of other things as well, but one of the most important things they could be a sign of is low potassium. Number 2 is mental fatigue. So not physical fatigue or physical weakness, but mental fatigue and irritability. If you're just irritable and you're not really sure why, or if you're just mentally very, very sluggish, that could definitely be low potassium. Number 3 is muscle cramps, muscle twitches, muscle spasms. If you've jumped up in the middle of the night with a leg cramp, that's almost assuredly low potassium. If you have muscle twitches under the eye or muscle spasms when you really shouldn't be having that kind of muscle movement, that could be low potassium. Number 4 is constipation and bloating. Your large intestine is lined with smooth muscle. That's what helps move the feces through there. If your smooth muscle doesn't have access to enough potassium, you can have constipation. And that's why an electrolyte drop that has potassium in it can help amazingly with constipation. Bloating is the same thing. You can't move the gas along if your smooth muscle is not operating optimally. Number 5, palpitations or arrhythmias. This is when you can actually feel your heart beating, or your heart is obviously not beating in a normal sinus rhythm. Your heart is made of the cardiac muscle, and that can definitely be affected if your potassium is low. Number 6 is edema or fluid retention. And so if you've got swollen ankles or your fingers are swollen and you can't get your ring off that you can normally get off, that could absolutely be low potassium, and potassium might help fix the edema around your ankles and the swelling in your fingers as well. Number 7, muscle aches and stiffness. So different than muscle tiredness or fatigue or weakness is if you wake up and you're just achy and stiff and you're like, I didn't really do anything yesterday. I don't know why I'm so achy and stiff. That could absolutely be low potassium. And now a bonus one. If your potassium gets super, super low, you can actually have numbness in your fingers and toes, in your hands and feet. And that's when your potassium has gotten really, really low. At that point, you need to see a doctor. And so for any of these signs that I've talked about in this video, I would go see your doctor, and don't be surprised if your potassium level is within normal limits. Remember, I said you can have severely depleted potassium levels in your body and have a normal serum potassium level. And that's why I like to eat lots of potassium-rich foods. I'm actually going to link a video either here or here of the 7 foods high in potassium that you can enjoy on a ketogenic diet. Sometimes when I have a cup of coffee, I love to put some electrolyte drops in that coffee just to make sure I'm getting enough potassium and magnesium and chloride and sodium and all that stuff. And I'll put a link down to my favorite electrolyte drops down in the show notes below. If you enjoyed this video, please click the subscribe button and the little bell button right beside it so that every time I get a bright idea, you'll be one of the very first to know. If my videos have benefited your health in some way, please consider becoming a patron. There's a Patreon link down below. You can click it. It's a quick sign up, and then you can throw a buck or two my way so that I have more time and more resources to make videos just like this. This is Dr. Barry. I'll see you next time.